This book, Baby in Childcare, by American pediatrician Dr. Benjamin Spock, changed the lives of a generation of parents. But 22 years before the publication of this venerable instruction manual, Dr. Spock was an Olympic gold medalist. But in which sport? The answer, in just 27 seconds. Yes. Good evening. Tonight, the TAIG pontoon takes three generations, each armed only with the paddles of their brain, out into the treacherous, shark-infested lake of life. They're to be thrown overboard with weights tied to them. Will they sink or swim upstream like trout and lay their eggs? And what of the next generation? Well, that would mean an extra rostrum and more questions. So let's stick with just the three and meet them right now, shall we? Thank you. Born between the mid-40s and the mid-60s, the baby boomers are now aged in their mid-40s and mid-60s. Proof positive that the year in which you're born contributes significantly to your eventual age. Say hi-de hi to Amanda Keller and Chrissy Amphlett. Amanda, hello.
Hello.
Chrissy. Now, do you remember back in 1980, you were playing with the Divinals at the South Adelaide Football Club in South Australia.
Don't remember that.
No. This will help. Do you remember at that particular function, a young man, a boy really, dressed in a yellow wind cheater?
Leaning... Yes, I do.
Well, do you?
Yeah.
Because you remember after science fiction, you leaned over and said, move, because I was leaning on one of the speakers. That was me.
Oh, wow.
That was me. Well, I'm touched you remember that.
I know. Look, I'm sorry, I didn't remember.
No, that's okay.
I didn't hit you or anything, did I?
No. You did say move to me a little meanly, but I kind of liked it.
Little boys like bad girls, don't they?
I know. Well, that's what I hear, and I'm counting on that tonight. So, Chrissy, best of luck to you and Amanda. Next Generation X, making up 60% of the workforce. The Australian economy rides on their back, hopefully in some sort of ergonomic papoose, or they'll herniate a disc and have to go on compo. Bend from the knees and follow OH&S guidelines for Charlie Pickering and Tim Minchin.
Red wine on my tea?
Yeah. No, you're wrong.
Okay.
Now, Tim, you've just finished a tour in Australia at the moment. In fact, as I understand, you're not here. You're actually in England at the moment. Is that right?
I am in England, yes.
Yeah, so why couldn't you be here tonight? What's so important in England that caused you to go over and... it's a protest of some sort, isn't it?
Yeah. I'm protesting the laws of time and space.
Yes. That's fair enough.
Is there something else?
No, Tim, no. It's just that, like, technically, because we don't go to air until after your tour is finished.
Yeah, I got that.
Oh, you get that.
I thought I might have bamboozled you. Yeah, it's the protest. Yeah.
But aren't you going back to England? Aren't you going to be in England? Aren't you protesting?
I'm in England now.
Yeah. Well, what the hell are you doing there?
A game show?
Yeah, no.
That's what you're doing here.
That's what you're doing here. That's all right. Well, Tim, for whatever reason and however you got here, I'm pleased you're here tonight.
Thanks for sort of having me.
Trying to get Gen Y to leave home is like trying to get a stain out of a My Chemical Romance T-shirt. You need a lot of bicarbonate of soda, and then why bother? They have youth on their side, a piece of leather around their wrist, and a tat on their hip. It's Josh Thomas and Brooke Satchwell. Hi, Josh.
Hello, Sean.
How are you? I'm going to have an awkward conversation with Brooke, if that's all right.
Yeah, please.
Hey, Brooke, you're in a film. You're doing a film at the moment. You're in a Disney film, is that right?
Princess Diaries 8, yes.
Yeah.
No.
You haven't done a Disney film?
No.
No?
No. Check the notes.
All this research must be for the next show.
Oh, hang on, you're right. No, I have done a Disney film.
Forget?
It just didn't feel very Disney. No, you're right.
Okay,
right.
So...
Subdivision.
Yeah, but how could you not... didn't you meet Walt?
There was a lot of animation not actually on set.
Oh, okay.
So, yeah,
right.
No.
But because it's distributed...
I'm sorry, I'm struggling with the time travel aspect. I feel like I need a hoverboard and maybe this is a young Christopher Lloyd. I don't know really what's going on.
Well, I don't know if it's a young Christopher Lloyd. I'm sorry, Josh. You know, I promised myself... Brooke, let me explain something to you. A lot of people say that I don't like Josh. They think that I'm
yeah,
mean.
Someone said that to me today on Twitter. They said, I think Sean doesn't like Josh. You can kind of tell. And
yeah, could you just shut up a minute?
Yeah.
Anyway.
You always know the ones you
they
love.
They say
it's
that
all
I don't
right.
like him, and I like him very much. You tell the folks at home that I do like you. Go on.
Well, I don't want to be presumptuous. Do you? Are you sure? Because backstage
moment.
You do, you're nice, but then sometimes out here, you know, you're mean.
Oh really?
but I think it's funny. But then I go home and then people say, why is Sean so mean to you? And I say, I don't know. I'm nothing but nice to him.
Well, but I do. If all right, look, I'm going to let you do that thing that you've always wanted to do on the show. That you remember that thing you told me you wanted to do, and I said no. You must never ever do that on the show. I'm going to let you do that now.
My special trick.
Yeah, do your special trick.
I could touch my eyebrow.
Impress Brooke.
Yeah, go on. I could touch my eyebrow to my nose.
Yeah, go and do that.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah. See, we're friends. We're friends.
Can
all right.
Can everyone do that, but most people just haven't thought to try?
No, we can't do it.
No one.
Give it a crack.
I'm not going to give it a crack.
Why?
Because then I'll be on telly trying to do it.
No, it's Josh's special thing.
Could you give it a crack?
It's my only skill.
Yeah. Is this Josh because you have no cartilage in your nose?
No, I just got a really kind of sloppy face.
Can everybody do this? Is this a normal thing? Can everyone do that?
I don't think I've got that much neck.
Right.
What, am I doing it?
What has this show become?
It hasn't even started yet. Okay, that's the end of the awkward conversation. We don't have to have it any more in this show. We're just going to get on with the show. Does that sound good?
What a waste of neck.
Oh, hang on. Just a reminder that tonight's questions and the Shroud of Turin have been verified by the Vatican.
Jesus Christ.
Take prides itself on being a family show. That means creating a show that's not only fun for mum and dad and you kids, but also for your pets. Mexican walking fish, ferrets, sea monkeys. They're in weeks to come, but tonight's segment is especially designed for your dog. And it's called Arf, Who Goes There? Now, I'll show our teams a still from a particular TV show, a very familiar one, and that it has a canine member of the cast missing. Now, teams, all they have to do is identify the dog gone. Okay, ready to play? Okay, we look over here on the magic screen. Here's the first. It's not really a still. It's more a cast shot, I guess. Tell me who's missing. Yes, Gen Y. What show,
the
Josh?
The show is Frasier.
Frasier, that's right.
And the dog is called...
I don't stay up that late.
Jack,
I can't
it?
Back
it's not
up.
Jack.
So it's no. not Jack, no. So you're locked out now. Baby Boomers.
Eddie?
It is Eddie. Well yeah. done. That's a point for you. Martin Crane's dog. Let's have a look at the next. This is the next still from a show. Tell me the name of the dog, Generation X.
We know that one.
That is the Family Brian. Guy. And the
guy.
Dog is Brian.
Brian, that's right. That's exactly what it is. Good, that's point for you. Next one here. You would know this one.
Oh.
Generation X.
It's Dukes of Hazzard. And yes. The dog is... Woodrow?
Woodrow? No, that was Simon Townsend's Wonderworld. No. No, this was Sheriff Roscoe's... bloodhound. It was a bloodhound.
Rear Admiral Snuggles?
No, it's... All right, I'll give you a point for that. Rear Admiral Snuggles.
He talks to him all the time.
His name is Flash. His name is Flash.
Oh,
Sheriff Roscoe's dog. Okay, last chance. Have a look at this. Tell me what the name of this dog is, Baby Boomers.
Well, the show is Wallace and Gromit. The fact that there's a W on his cup says that he's probably Wallace. So you say it out loud and clear. Gromit!
Correct! Yeah. Well done. Yay! It's been going so quiet, I'm going to give you 5 points for that. Put 5 points out there for the Baby Boomers. After the break, more fun than a barrel of monkeys and only half as cruel. That's next on Tag. Leave him alone, Tim. Josh, are you okay?
Yeah, I'm all right.
Okay. Hello again. Now, very remiss of me, I did not mention this book. This is Chrissy Amphlett's autobiography. And you remember, you bought this out a few years ago, but you've
2005.
But you put some stuff in there that's happened
since. I've just added four new chapters.
Yeah, what, did you forget a whole lot of stuff?
Well, I didn't know how to end it. So I thought my publisher very kindly asked me to do another 4 or 5 chapters. So that's, you know, it has been updated.
That's right.
Is Tonight included in the last chapter?
Oh, everything.
You win! Okay, three heads divided into thirds, mixed up and reassembled. Yes, it's all the fun of craniofacial surgery gone wrong, but without those pesky malpractice suits. That's the fun of Frankenface.